Hi guys, it's me, it's Monika. I know I've been missing in action for, gosh, I don't know, quite a while, right? I think almost a month. And this is just going to be a quick update. I'm not going to do any product reviews or talk about anything, but just an update on what's been going on. So if you're here for a product review, bear with me. In my next video, I do have a ton of things I have to review, and I just haven't had a chance to do it. But I'm going to take you back in time towards the beginning of March, which is, I think, where probably when my last video came out in the beginning of March. And I was getting ready to go to convention to Louisville. And I went to Louisville for our annual convention. I'm going to, you know, I'm probably going to do this more talking vlog because I'll probably superimpose some photos. But I shared a room with one of the managers in our company because Jared didn't come with me. And he stayed home so he could really, you know, be here in case something happened with mom and stuff like that. So I really appreciated that a lot. So I shared a room with Maggie, one of my managers in the office, and sort of hung around with the relocation director and a couple of agents, and we did a whole bunch of different things. So one night we went out to night out where we all met up in a sort of had like a barbecue dinner. And then there was a ghost walk afterwards. I didn't go on the ghost walk. I didn't feel all that well. So I ended up going back to the room with Maggie. And the next day, there was just a bunch of awards, a bunch of different ceremonies going on at the convention. I did make it in time to do my education part of it that I had to do all day Sunday. One night, we went out to dinner to this place under the bridge. It was really an interesting restaurant. It's a picture of a group of us right before we went into the restaurant, taken on the outside. It was really interesting, from the service to the menu to where the restrooms were. It was very, very interesting, but it was a fun night. So convention was really good. No major delays coming back. Had horrible delays going out. Was supposed to fly out super early on a Saturday morning, and I got up at 3:30. I got up to get ready because we'd have to leave the house by 4:30 to get me to we'd have to leave the house by 3:30 to get me to Manchester for 4:15 when my flight was boarding. So I was getting ready and I got a ting from Southwest Airlines. What a pain. And they had postponed, canceled my flight and put me on a flight out on Monday, which did not do anything for me because I had a bunch of things I had to do on Sunday. So long story short, I made a number of phone calls, got nowhere, got put on hold. Finally, I went to Twitter and I started venting on Twitter and I got immediate attention. I was put on a flight later that day out of Manchester that was delayed a couple of times. There was a storm, so that was delayed. And I ended up flying down to Orlando only to go back up to Kentucky. But that was the only way I could get to Kentucky on Saturday. And so I arrived, it was like near midnight on Friday night, and it was kind of on Saturday night, and it was kind of a little bit leery for me to go out into this airport where the Ubers were on one section and there was nobody there. So long story short, I caught a ride with some realtors from Colorado to the hotel we were staying at, and the convention ended up being super nice. I came back from convention and had 2 days in the office, and then I took my mother. We went for a girls weekend. I'll superimpose some photos. We went for a girls weekend. I picked up my mom and we surprised my sister. It was my sister's birthday on the 16th, which was the day I came home from convention, so they celebrated it that weekend. And my niece did an Airbnb and we stayed up there in the Conway area of New Hampshire, and it was just really nice. And we got up there late Saturday night dinner out. I had a fabulous meal. Oh my gosh, the meal was so good. It was an Italian restaurant, and I had like mussels and different seafood. I just really loved it. It was so, so good. And then Sunday, we're out the door back home by 10, and then, hold on, what?
You're not supposed to be up.
I'm not supposed to be up. I just shut the door on him. I'm up for a few minutes. Long story short. So anyway, Sunday we came home and dropped my mother off and, you know, all of that. And I went to work Monday. And I promptly, Monday afternoon, got sick as a dog. I mean, literally sick. I barely made it home. And I'm not going to go into the gory details, but I was chained to the toilet with a bucket in my lap because I was so sick. I thought I had food poisoning, and I thought, oh my God, you know, the food I ate was food poisoning, and it was bad, and it ended up not being. Ended up getting a stomach flu. My mother got it, my sister got it, my husband got it. We were all sick all week long, so I never ever got to do a video or anything. And my ear surgery was for the 30th, so not too sure when this is going to go public, but the 30th, as the time of filming, was yesterday. That's why Jay came in here and said I wasn't supposed to be up, because I'm not supposed to be up. I'm not supposed to be up alone anyway, so, and he's in the other room, so I'm not really alone. But, so I was so sick, and I was worried that that was going to postpone my ear surgery. And of course, before you have any kind of surgery, you have to have a COVID test. And I'm like thinking, oh my gosh, it all worked out well. I got my COVID test. That was clean. I went and did my surgery yesterday morning. And what he did, as I don't have any earrings on because of the fact I can't do anything to weigh it down, he was able to do the least invasive of what the three potentials were. So he was able to go in the front, take some bone, some cartilage, and rebuild the part where my eardrum was blown out, patch the hole and all that. I don't know quite yet how successful it's going to be ultimately, but initially after the surgery, the surgeon thought it went really well. So I've been home since yesterday. Not supposed to be lifting, bending, driving. Not supposed to be doing a whole bunch of things. So I haven't really done anything. I've just been on the couch, on my chair. Like I said, I've got a lot of things to review, and just haven't even done any of them. I've just been so out of it, just not feeling good at all. So I have because they had to give me a breathing tube. I don't know why, but they had to give me a breathing tube, so my throat is all raw and hurts to swallow it. In the mornings, this morning I got up, I couldn't even talk. So it's going to be a while. On the really good news front is, while I was sick for the stomach thing, my second bike came in. Some of you know I have an electric bike, and I have a Pedego Boomerang, which I love. I call her Glenda. She's the one with the basket. Try to superimpose. She's the one with the baskets in the front and the matching chain guard and fenders and all that with little butterflies on it. Anyways, I love Glenda. She's an awesome bike for street biking, long trails. The battery lasts forever, but she's not good in sand or dirt. So I had been eyeballing another bike, and I finally got her in. I also wanted to have a suspension put on her, so I got that. So her name is Sassy Witch, and she's a blue bike. So I post this here so you can see what she looks like. So yeah, I'm a 2 e-bike owner. I think that's kind of cool, you know. I mean, I enjoy biking. I'm optimistic because I'm standing here straight that I can get on my bike, but I enjoy biking, and these two bikes are completely different. Glenda is easy to get in. You just put it's a low entry. You just put your foot over, scoot your butt up on the seat, hit your little throttle slowly, and you can go, and then you start pedaling, and you take your throttle off, and you pedal your brains out. The furthest I've gone on Glenda is about 30 miles, and we still had more than half the battery left. The Element Sassy is a little bit different, a little bit harder. I'm going to bend the bike over to mount her, and she's mainly going to be my beach baby. So if I'm going to like Old Orchard Beach in Maine, and I'm going to be biking along the sand, that's where I'm going to bring her. So that I thought was good. So I really love my bikes. Other than that, my Mohs surgery has not happened yet. I have had two postponements. So I think it's the 15th of April is when I meet with the plastic surgeon, because they both have to be on standby. They both have to be there to do this together, and he can assess this. But I'm still thinking this is going to happen in May, maybe now pushed out to June. But I'm really glad, because the ear was more painful, continuously having earaches and all that. So that was more painful for me. And I'm just hoping that it isn't going to be super unsightly. You know, when you have a spot like that in the middle of your face, it's kind of like really grosses you out. So I get that taken, the ear taken care of. I have a follow-up visit. I'm hoping to get back to a normal routine. This is the longest I've been on my feet to record this video. And Jay has been like hovering around me like a mother hen, like crazy. So, which is good. But yeah, it's April. By the time you see this, it'll be, well, April 1st is Friday. I don't know if you're going to see it Thursday or Friday, but April, spring. We are heavily into mud season right now, although we did have a bit of a snowstorm not too long ago, but it's been really cold. So yeah, mud season, brown season in New Hampshire is not pretty, but it is what it is. So I've got like some hair pieces that I want to talk about in a future video, more buns and wraps, and I also have some, I have two products coming from Octoly. I don't know if they're going to arrive before I do my next video or not, but if they do, I will talk about that. I also took a bunch of pictures of my cancer spot, my basal cell, and I'm going to share that whole process with you in a separate video. But I just wanted to come on and just jibber jabber about this because I know I've had a number of you send me messages through my email, and it's very heartfelt that, you know, you guys are thinking about me. So I really appreciate that. I'm going to take this thing out of my ear, and I have eardrops I have to put in. So I'm not looking forward to doing that, but I'm going to do that. My whole side of my face here is a little swollen still and hurts to the touch. So when I sit down, I'll probably do a quick edit, add photos, upload this. And then I'm just going to ice my ear and hope for the best. Hope for the best. So anyways, that's it for me right now. And I hope you guys are doing good. I'm hoping to record a video on Saturday, more of a normal video. Hopefully it'll be this weekend. I'm hoping that I have enough, vinegar, piss and vinegar, to do that. So anyways, that's it. Thanks so much for hanging in there.